A quick Google of luxury hotels in the Austrian ski village of Lech brings up a flurry of options, with many boasting a perfect online review average of 5 stars. We're staying in Severin's, it doesn't countenance apostrophes, the Alpine Retreat in Lech, and it only has an average, at the time of writing, of 4.3 out of 5. This makes me wonder what exactly is going on at the other hotels. Do they offer unlimited crystal champagne, diamond-encrusted slippers and helicopter transfers to the top of the ski slopes? Let's knock off 0.5 because it's not ski in, ski out. It sits on a quiet road in the northeast corner of the town, but then, you can be chauffeur-driven to the resort and back in luxury Mercedes SUVs, so have 0.25 back. But aside from that, it can do no wrong. It ranks as not just one of the best places I've stayed in a ski resort, but as one of the best hotels I've ever stayed in anywhere. The needle on the hotel quality-o-meter is given an initial jolt by our knockout bedroom, a senior suite. Personally, I'd rename it Heavenly Snug Lair of Luxury Suite, perhaps. Rustic alpine coziness is blended masterfully with sleek modernity, beautiful wooden wardrobes, floors, walls and ceilings in harmony with a super swish bathroom, but be warned, the toilet is in a see-through glass cubicle, something some may find off-putting. We drape ourselves over the huge sofa in the living room, snuggle on the gigantic round love chair, sleep like babies on the king-size bed and nod approvingly at the statement Italian lighting. The tech is top too. We have a TV opposite the bed, neatly hung in a recess, and another in the living room. Plus there's a Bluetooth hi-fi, which we use principally to play nursery rhymes for our toddler through, and lighting controlled by an iPad, which clips neatly into a holder on the wall. The interiors have been designed by Reinhard Strasser, who is clearly at the peak of his powers. More commendations are earned by the indoor pool. The hotel only has 9 bedrooms, all suites, yet the 12.5-meter pool would do a hotel with 50 bedrooms proud. I go just the once and have the place to myself. I feel like royalty. And again, it's a design triumph. Dimly lit, which I find rather arresting, and with rough-hewn granite walls and underwater loungers just below the surface at the shallow end, it's stylish enough for a Vogue cover shoot. Vogue would probably be tempted to put the food on the cover too. It's cooked with supreme skill and flair. The hotel recently took on 25-year-old Kevin Shalai as head chef. What a hire. Though he doesn't have a Michelin star, the food is at least one star standard. He takes ordinary dishes, and makes them extraordinary. Like Eggs Benedict at breakfast, which is cooked with smoke and contained within a jar that's opened at the table. Mouth-watering, and the first hotel breakfast I've ever had that came with a bit of theater. And he doesn't do salad, he does an exquisite Alice in Wonderland-esque work of art vegetable garden, beautifully arranged with tiny pieces of radish, carrot and pumpkin. Unfortunately, though, he doesn't do cheap. Even a starter will cost you your children's inheritance. The service, meanwhile, is similarly spiffing. All the staff members are wonderfully helpful and great with our 18-month-old, who is introduced to all the chefs, given lots of hugs and generally made to feel like a superstar. To top it all off, Lech just happens to be in one of the world's greatest ski areas, Arlberg. Over 300 kilometers, 186 miles, of pistes link Lech, St. Anton, St. Christoph, Steuben and Zers and the jaw-dropping landscapes they nestle in, which receive an average of 29 feet of snow each winter. And the taxi transfer from Innsbruck Airport. It's worthy of a movie. Sold? Thought so.